Guys, this is Donut Movies, and today I got another World of Warcraft lore video. So due to a few requests I have gotten, I finally decided to do a video covering the Blackrock Foundry, and straight up, there really isn't too much lore about this apart from some of the questlines and the dungeon journal and the, I guess the raid journal, it's the same thing. So that is why this video is a bit shorter, but I'll try to explain it the best I can and also give you the lore that we have, covering the backstory of the entire Foundry and the Blackrock clan. I will also give you a brief description about each boss, just as I did for my Heimel video, so I will explain how they got to the Blackrock Foundry and why we're fighting them. So without further ado, let's just get into the lore. So we all know that the Blackrock Foundry is the center of the Blackrock clan, which is exactly why I'm going to give you a bit of a background behind the Blackrock clan, since they're like the central part of the entire operation. Now some of this stuff is alternate universe, but I think a lot of the lore was retconned, and some of the changes are also added to our actual universe, and I'm guessing Draenor looked almost exactly like the current version that we are in now, the alternate one. So I'm guessing most of this stuff is actually kind of the same apart from the entire Ironhorde thing. So, as we know, the Blackrock clan is in Gorgrond, mainly the northern part of it, because the Blackrock Foundry is there, and currently you see this massive foundry, this gigantic building there, and all these machines, but it wasn't always like that. I mean, that part of the Gorgrond is the ancestral home of the clan, and that is where they smelted the Blackrock ore ages ago, which I'm going to explain in a bit. It is a bit more than it sounds like. So, only recently the foundry has really been built to what it is, and it was like completely expanded, and they're actually still expanding it, or at least they were still expanding it. Now, ever since the Ironhorde was formed, the Blackrock Foundry has been growing at an insane pace, like ridiculous pace, and you can actually see that by the number of the slaves the Ironhorde has captured, and that are working on expanding the actual facility, I guess. And essentially, the Foundry is the heart of the Ironhorde, that is the source for their power. They don't have the demon blood, they don't have any power like that, but they have the machines, they have the amazing armor, the weapons and everything like that, and this is the source of their power. And at this point, currently, it is considered that we have killed Blackhand lore-wise in this alternate universe, and that is exactly why when you watch the 6.1 cinematic, you see that the Ironhorde has mainly been defeated, as we destroyed their main source of power that they're building from. Now, don't let the name Blackrock fool you, as even though, as I said, the Blackrock clan is the central part of it, there are a lot of additions to it that really add up to the power that they had until recently, and without them it would definitely not even be near to where it was. One of the additions is the Thunderlord clan that has just been legendary for hunting down the giants, beasts, and all sorts of these different creatures, even the giants of Draenor, like the Earth Giants, that are now extinct. And they have joined the Ironhorde and they have aided them quite a bit. They had helped them by providing captured beasts all across the world, and even giants like the Gron and the Ogron, which serve as the workforce in the Foundry, and they had definitely helped a lot in the explosive expansion of the entire Foundry. Another addition is also the Burning Blade clan that doesn't really have as much of an impact, but one of the bosses, which I'm going to explain in a bit, helps in enchanting the blades and just general production and the quality of the equipment they use, so they also help the Blackrock clan. So right now I'm just going to list down the bosses and give a little backstory on all of them, but I won't go in the exact order as it is in the raid, I will kind of go by significance and by the entire storyline, so let's just get into it. So, in my opinion, apart from Blackhand, the most important boss, I guess, it isn't even that much of a boss, or just a big part of the entire Foundry, is the Blast Furnace. Now, this is literally the heart of the Foundry and their main source of power. Now, I did mention earlier that the Blackrock clan was known for their power to smelt the Blackrock ore, which was almost impossible to do, and it was their secret for a long time. But now, once we have gotten into the heart of their ancestral home, or the heart of the Foundry, we have really discovered what is going on. It turns out they have captured an ancient fury, or an elemental of fire, and they have been using its powers in order to do what they're actually doing and smelt the ore, and it is a very vile thing to do, especially for an orc, as it takes a dark shaman in order to subjugate and enslave an elemental, and judging that the orcs are a shamanistic society and they value the elementals, it is a really bad thing to do for an orc, and that is why their clan is really sort of being evil, but I guess it's all different perspectives. Now, the most important boss after the Blast Furnace, although I'm not really even talking about the bosses when I mention the Blast Furnace, that is just like the central part of the entire Foundry, but the most important boss of the Foundry is Blackhand, as he's the last boss and he's the leader of the Blackrock clan, and he's pretty much the brain behind the entire thing. He is the one that started the entire engine that was expanding, and he also kept the entire engine running, and I will probably make a lore video on him at some point, like an updated one. I have one on the channel which is really bad, but I'm thinking about like making an actual video on him, because he's quite an interesting figure, and he was actually killed during the wars in our timeline by Orgrim Doomhammer, who later on took over the Horde, and in this alternate one, we were the ones to kill him, effectively stopping pretty much the entire operation of the Iron Horde. Now, another important boss is Chromog. Now, Chromog is a Megadon, and I would actually suggest you guys to watch my lore speculation video covering the evolution of Giants on Draenor if you want to understand how the Megadon came to be. But pretty much the Megadon that are the direct descendants of the Earth Giants or the Breakers that once walked the world of Draenor, and it is even suggested that they were built by the Titans themselves. So what happens is that when the miners were expanding the Foundry, they have discovered the giant Megadon, who decided to help them for some reason instead of just fighting them, and after that he has just been helping them by using his gigantic like stone fists in order to shape the metal plates for their giant armors and all the big cannons and everything like that. And in my opinion, this is a really weird lore decision, as I don't personally think a Megadon would willingly serve the orcs, who are pretty much like so tiny they're like the gnomes in comparison to them, but I guess he might not have had any other choice. I don't really know how intelligent the Megadon are, and he may have seen that he is outnumbered, and he might as well help them instead of just being killed. Now, another important Foundry boss, in my opinion, is Gruul, who in our timeline was the most feared name throughout all of Draenor. He was known as the Dragon Killer, and pretty much I would say he was almost the king of Draenor, and later on Outland, as he survived the breaking of the world. But in this timeline, he was actually captured by the Thunderlord clan and subjugated, and they even cut off his hand in order for him to work more efficiently, and this is just one of the examples that shows how powerful the Iron Horde has gotten. If they were able to capture someone such as Gruul and just turn him into a laborer and a slave, and even cut off his hand. Now, after these bosses, you also have the other bosses that aren't really that important, but they are kinda interesting and they have a role of their own, so I'm just gonna list them down. The first one is Beastlord Darmek of the Thunderlord clan, who has joined them together with the rest of the Thunderlords, and he is responsible for most of the beasts that they have, and he has aided the Iron Horde quite a lot by subjugating all sorts of creatures all across Draenor, so he was a pretty big part of the Iron Horde. Now, the next one is Flamebender Khagrez of the Burning Blade clan that I mentioned earlier, and the Burning Blade clan is known for their blade masters, and they actually do still exist in our timeline, and Khagrez is responsible for enchanting the weapons with the essence of the flame, pretty much bolstering the strength of their blades and the power that they have, and essentially bolstering the strength of the entire Iron Horde, so it is also a big part of it. Now, next to the two core parts, or I guess the two helpers, you also have two other important figures that kinda serve the Iron Horde and just keep the entire engine going. The first one is Operator Togar, and he is the perfect example of that. He handles the supply lines and makes sure that everything is delivered to the Iron Horde forces all across Draenor throughout the entire railing system that they have built and actually planned on expanding as well. He also coordinates a big part of the army, sending battalions to certain destinations, most notably Teledor in the battle against the Draenei, so he is a pretty big part of the Iron Horde. Now, while we have Togar for the ground forces, we also have the Iron Maidens for the naval forces of the Iron Horde. Now, Geran is the admiral and the leader of the naval forces, together with her maidens Marak and Sorka, which serve as her lieutenants and sort of her helpers, and they're at the top of the chain for any Horde naval activity, and they're also a big part of it. And apart from the integral part that I just mentioned, you also have Hansgar and Franzok, who are mainly just a muscle. They don't really have any big chain of command, there aren't really anything that important, and I don't even think they're specified from which clan they are from, but it is said that they're brothers, and at one point they were faced off in Makgora, which is a saint battle ritual for the orcs and pretty much a battle to the death, but they actually refused to kill each other since they're brothers, and for that they were banished from their clan, and they lived in the wilds for a long time. And once they heard about the Iron Horde forming, they finally decided to join them and actually put their strength to good use instead of wandering all across Draenor. And the last sort of irrelevant boss, I guess, is Orgorgon, who is a Goron and probably the biggest Goron there is. And he isn't really related to any Iron Horde activity, but since the Goron live underground, they had sensed the ore storage of the Iron Horde, especially the Blackrock ore. And since the Goron are attracted to the ore, he pretty much came to see what it was all about, like the entire storage. So he's more of a pest in the entire raid, he isn't really like a commander of the Iron Horde or anything like that. Alright, that is all I have for this lore lesson. As I said at the start, there really isn't all that much lore about this. It isn't like a lore heavy raid like Uldar is, for example, or maybe even Icecrown Citadel. But apart from that, that is pretty much all we have about the bosses, and I honestly think it is quite interesting. And I thought I would do a video on this because I know you guys are currently raiding Blackrock Foundry. There isn't really anything else you can do at the moment, and it is a bit more fun when you know what the backstory is behind it when you're actually doing the thing. Now, do give me some feedback on what you think and also what you would like to see. And if you like the video, don't forget to hit that like button and also subscribe if you're not subscribed already, as it really helps out the channel and keeps all these videos going. Thanks a lot for taking the time out of your day to watch this video, and see you next time.